So, Coach, what's the first couple days been like for you? I know you were out here yesterday, and you were here recruiting before.
Yeah. It's kind of a whirlwind. You know, we just got through playing our biggest game of the year for us.
Yeah.
Guys had their finals. So our team flew in today. Most of the coaches have been out recruiting. Mm-hmm. The coordinators have been back, you know, preparing practice-wise. But we got to do the best we can to get ready for a very good football mm-hmm. team.
What are you expecting out of this matchup between the two teams?
They're going to be a tough, hard-nosed football team. You know, Coach Long is a great football coach. His teams are always well-prepared, physical, tough guys. On defense, they're going to have a great clue how to stop the option. I think it's 8 or 9 straight versus service academies. You know, most of us run the option, so they're going to have a great clue of what we do.
When Rocky was talking about this game, he said he was just excited for San Diego fans, having Navy and the hometown team and that whole atmosphere. What are you expecting out of the atmosphere?
Well, we're normally excited when we come here because it's normally a home game for us, but when we play the Aztecs, obviously we're not the home team anymore, but we're excited. We love coming here. I think it's our fourth time here. We've been here 4 times, and the people of the bowl game are great. The people are friendly. Great weather, great food. Hopefully we'll play better. We've enjoyed ourselves every time we've come, except we've lost all of our games, so hopefully we can do better.
And it seems like your team really started hitting its stride like mid-October. Would you say now you guys are playing your best football at this point of the year?
Until last week. We didn't play so well last week. And you got to give credit to Army. But, we've played much better the second half of the season. I think some of our guys have gotten healthy, especially our quarterback, so that helps. And, yeah, we're playing pretty good right now, but none of that stuff in the past matters. You know, hopefully we're ready to play this week.
Coach, the fact that you guys only have like a 10-day turnaround for the bowl, how does that affect what you're able to do?
It's not the most ideal situation for a bowl game, but they're not going to call the game off. You know, we can't say, hey, can we get a couple more days? And so, like I said, we just got to do the best we can. These guys are going to serve our country, so they're going to be in missions and things that are going to be pretty hard. And so they're going to have to find a way to get through things and try to, find a solution to problems. So we just got to do the best we can.
But I know they were in exams for a while. Were the coaches at least able to start planning and breaking down film and doing stuff ahead of time? Or
no, because the Army game is so big for mm-hmm. us. I mean, some of our graduate assistants do the initial stuff, but the full-time guys, we had to keep all our arrows mm-hmm. towards Army. We didn't want to, we have great respect for San Diego State, mm-hmm. but we had to prepare for Army first.
And then in terms of Paul Questenberry, can you just talk about what he's meant for your program? And obviously, we're all excited to have a San Diego kid back here, but what has he meant for your program?
Paul Questenberry is our team. He symbolizes who we are, tough, a great human being, works hard, keeps his mouth quiet. He's who we are. Undersized, people bypass him because of his size, but he's not afraid of anybody, against Ohio State, Notre Dame, everybody plays hard with everybody.
And obviously he's gone through some different things, with his brother and everything this year. How do you think he's handled that?
I think he's handled it as best you can. I mean, it's affected him. It's affected their entire family. He's been pretty vocal about it within our team and in our team meetings and team settings. It was pretty blunt and straightforward with us. And, all of his teammates have rallied around him and his family to try to do the best we can to support his brother. But, all of our team loves Quiz. We love his family. So, it's exciting for him to come home, like you said, and finish out his career. And hopefully we can send him out the right way.
Thank you. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
So first, just what was your initial reaction when you saw that you guys were going to be coming to San Diego?
Just couldn't be more excited, playing in front of my home. Friends, family, all going to be there, so it's definitely the best option that could have been for us.
And did you ever get recruited by San Diego State or ever think to go to San Diego State, or did you know Navy from the beginning?
I definitely thought about it. I didn't really get recruited by them that much. I got, one letter from one of the coaches back when I was in high school, and it was a handwritten letter, so that was pretty cool. But that was it. That was all I heard from them.
And do you have any memories of maybe going to the Poinsettia Bowl growing up, or just going to Qualcomm? Like, is this, you know, a pretty cool deal for you to play in your hometown stadium?
Yeah, I've seen a lot of games in Qualcomm Stadium. We grew up Charger fans, and my parents were season ticket holders, so I got to go to a bunch of games, and I love that stadium. I played my CIF championship there for my junior year with the El Costa Canyon Mavericks, so definitely a special place for me.
And in terms of just being home for Christmas, when was the last time you were home for Christmas?
Last year, I think we flew out on Christmas, so I guess that counts, but not really. So it's been a while.
And I know you guys are a football family, so are all three of you going to be home? And if so, what does that kind of mean to have all three of you guys here? Because when you're all playing football, it can probably be crazy to get everyone together.
Yeah, it's awesome, you know. Just for it to line up like this, for all of us to get together around holidays, it's definitely perfect, and couldn't be more happy about it.
And how do you think you've changed in these 4 years, you know, going to the academy and just as a person? Like, what has this meant for you?
Just dealing with whatever gets thrown at you in life. You know, you get a lot of days where you got to accomplish a lot of things, and you just got to, you know, not get overwhelmed by it and stick to the plan and just grind it out, and eventually, you know, you'll make it happen.
And now obviously your family has gone through a lot this year, so does it make it a little more special knowing you get to play here and have everyone kind of around you and be together?
Absolutely. You know, my family showed really great support for my brother and all his treatment, and they've actually been able to be there for him in Houston and look after him and you know, be there when my parents can't, and that's been awesome. And they also get to come to me and my little brother Scotty's games, and you know, they're just real fired up about everything, and they're real more than willing to help out with my brother. So I'm definitely real grateful for the great family that we have.
And did you ever expect to end your career here in San Diego? Is this something you ever even thought about?
No, I never thought about it. I just, when I saw that we got the Poinsettia Bowl this year, I was like, wow, I really need to make that bowl. Like, that would be out of this world. I can't even believe, like, how happy I would be. And here we are, so I'm excited.
And just in terms of your family, like I talked about being a football family, kind of what has this sport meant to you, especially having your teammates there for you this past year?
You know, football has been my life for as long as I can remember. I've always been a part of a team, you know, and I've never enjoyed anything that I do more than being a part of a team, and especially here, you know. These guys are my brothers, and I'm going to be friends with them for life, and I've been able to lean on them, and I think that what I've been going through and sharing my experiences with them has made them, you know, a lot stronger and more appreciative of where they're at right now. So I'm glad I got to share that with them, and they can benefit from our situation.
And then just in terms of you personally as a football player, you know, your coach was saying you're the strong guy, but maybe overlooked for size and all this stuff. Do you feel like you've always had to kind of overcome a little something and prove something?
I wouldn't say I'd have to overcome and prove something to anyone besides myself. You know, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter how tall you are, how strong you are, how fast you run. It's what you do on game day, and that's all that matters to me. And you know, that comes down to one person and one person only, and that's yourself. And you got to control that. It's your destiny, and you make that decision every day.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it.
No problem.